Hey you guys! Okay, I did a little bit of damage. I know that I said I wasn't gonna order from Sephora Australia anymore. I was boycotting them for a while because I was really angry. But now I've simmered down and realized that my anger isn't gonna help the situation, and they're not gonna give me my points, that's it. So anyways, I, being a beauty insider white level, I ordered a few things on Sephora, but I also wanted to show you what I got for the May Bellabox. This is going to be the last Bellabox that I will be receiving. I've actually already canceled my subscription. And don't get me wrong, I do like the products that they have sent me. I think if you are new to makeup or don't really have a lot of things in your collection or really like to experiment, that this may be a good thing. It's like $18 a month. I'm not sponsored by Bellabox. I'm just telling you guys what it is. Yeah, but like I said, I canceled my subscription because I really just wanted to test it out and see what's in there. I didn't really want to accumulate any more makeup or skincare or whatever. I'd like to stick to the ones that I already know that I love. And so that's why I canceled my subscription. There you go. So this is the May box. It looks exactly like the March box that I had before. Let's see. I've just taken out of its packaging, but I haven't actually opened it, so let's do that together. I don't know what's in here. Weekend Skin, it says. May 2018. I'm not going to look at what's in on the card right now. The first thing I see here is... ooh, why is this open? It's not screwed on properly. Hopefully nothing is messed up. Okay, it's sealed anyway. That's good. But this is the Sukin Hydrating Facial Mask, paraben-free skincare that doesn't cost the earth. Combining mango, seed butter, and avocado oil to protect the skin's moisture barrier with pineapple and papaya extracts for a nourished complexion. So that's what that looks like. Okay. I've never tried any Sukin product. Australia owned and made, and it's carbon neutral. So how do you use this? Apply to damp face and neck to relax and allow it to penetrate for 15 minutes and then rinse off with warm water and washcloth. So it is something that you really do need to wash off. I wanted something that is like a leave-in overnight mask kind of thing. But hey, I'm getting a lot of Model Co products from them. But before that, this is the Revlon Professional Unique One All-in-One Hair Treatment. Ooh. It's a leave-in spray mask. That's what it is. That's what it looks like. And there is how much product in it? 10 real benefits, it says. And it's got 0.3 fluid ounces or 9 mils. What does it claim? These are supposed to be sold in salons. Yeah, I've never seen this. It has 10 real benefits, but what are the benefits? Is it on the card? Maybe I'll read that afterwards. I have a foil packet of the Nutrimetics BB cream. I wonder what shade this. Light to medium. This is probably going to be too light for me anyways. Then a Model Co. Baked Highlighter in Moonshine. That's what that is. I've got way too many highlighters already. Let's have a look at what this particular highlighter looks like. Oh, that looks cute. So that's the highlighter there. It's marbled and baked. Might be too dark for somebody who's got pale skin, so this might be more of a blush topper or a shimmery bronzer. But like I said, I've got enough highlighters, so I'm probably gonna put this away to be placed in a giveaway pack. Okay, now there is a charcoal deep stain remover white glow extra strength whitening toothpaste. I am very curious about this because I've got yellowy teeth. I don't know if it shows on camera, but I've got yellowy teeth. I don't smoke. No, not at all. I drink a little bit of coffee and soda, like Coke Zero or Pepsi Max, the no sugar ones. But I don't know. I'll try this out and see if it's actually going to work. Maybe what I would actually do is take a picture of my teeth up close and then use it for a week, see how it goes, use it for another 2 weeks. Maybe for as long as it I will use it up. That's what I was trying to say. And every week I will do like a picture of my teeth to see if there's any kind of change. So that's cool. I like that. And then here is a Inbachi, is that what it's called? Dry touch moisturizing, smooth finish brightening, all skin types. Brightening hand and nail cream. Okay, that's what it's in the packaging. I don't know. It says brightening hand and nail cream instantly brightens the skin for more youthful hands. Formulated with SPF 15 for extra protection on hands against harmful UV rays. Made in Australia. Okay, cool. Let's see. By the way, whenever you get a Bellabox, you actually get an ingredients card on it. Like all the ingredients that are in every single product that's inside. So then you can see if you are allergic to any of them. So let's see. What about that Revlon thing? So it says that the Unique One hair treatment is an all-in-one product, providing your hair with 10 main benefits to make the hair more flexible and manageable. From repairing dry and damaged locks to maintaining your hairstyle, this hair treatment is your go-to. Okay, you will get one of the following scents: classic, coconuts, or lotus flower. Which one do I have then? How do I know? Or do I just smell it? Huh. Doesn't smell like coconut. It's probably lotus flower, I think. Anyway, gonna try that. Gonna try all the other stuff, with the exception of the baked highlighter. I'm going to put this in a giveaway box. Okay, pretty good, Bellabox. Let's see. But like I said, I already canceled my subscription with them. So, yeah. Ah! How do I fix this? Anyway, I'll worry about that later. Now, I'll show you what I got from the Sephora. They had 10% off for Beauty Insider's white level back just last weekend. You're seeing this on a Tuesday, so just last week they had that. And one other thing, if you are in Australia, I would recommend that you download the app Shopback. If you are familiar with what Ebates is in the States, Shopback is a cashback online application. And Sephora is on it, as well as the Iconic, ASOS, and a few other places. Again, I am not sponsored. I'm just letting you guys know that this thing exists. And if you want to get cashback from your online shopping, it's probably a good idea to do that. The percentages just vary depending on the store. But so what I've done, because Sephora also has Afterpay, Afterpay here in Australia is a, how do I describe it? But I use an app for me to be able to pay via Afterpay, which means that I will be able to pay for my purchases in 4 installments, an installment every fortnight. So in a span of 2 months, it splits my bill. So that if I wanted to purchase something big but don't have the cash for it right away, but I know that I'm gonna be good for it in a span of 2 months, then I do that. So what I done was go into the Shopback app, clicked on the Sephora website, did my purchasing, and then paid via Afterpay, so that I have a total of $263 Australian, less, I think I'm getting 3.5% back. So something around like $9, I think I'm getting back from that. Not a lot, but then whatever is, then the 263 is also divided into 4 payments. So the first thing that I really wanted to get, and I had been contemplating on it, is the Zoeva Rose Gold 15 Brush and Clutch Collection. I tried to get the fake one from AliExpress and they came back with like Teflon bristles that is useless. Seriously, I was like, this is not what I expected, right? So that was a burn. It's a good thing I only paid like less than $10 for it, I think. I sort of like had to throw out all of the brushes because they were just useless to me. And I did buy a few Dalium brushes during IMAT Sydney last year, but was quite disappointed with the eye brushes because they're so scratchy. The face brushes I have no issues, but the eye brushes were so scratchy. So I've been contemplating on this. I was thinking, oh, I'll get it from the Zoeva website because if I spend a certain amount, the shipping is free anyway. But then Sephora had the 10% off, so it actually is the same price as the Zoeva website, but I don't have to pay for it and for the full price. Anyway, too much talking, Meg. So it comes like this. It comes with a pouch that has Zoeva on it. It is rose gold. So these are all of the brushes. Let's open it up. Okay. I was specifically interested with the eye brushes, but I also could use a little bit, a few more face brushes. This one is an angled face brush. The first ones of these kind that I got were from Sigma. This is really soft. Wow. I might actually come back to using brushes for my foundation, but I do use my Real Techniques sponge for that. So this one is, oh, it says actually on here, Color Love Makeup. And this is the Zoeva 103 Defined Buffer. And then I'll go through the eye brushes first. This is the powder brush. So it splays out like that. So freaking soft. Every time I go into a Sephora here in Australia, I would touch it. And I would be like, wow. But then, do I need it? I've been contemplating for a long time. I have here the Luxe Face Paint, which is like a highlight, a contour brush. Like it's pretty much like the NARS Ida brush. I think it is what it is, but ew, freaking soft, man. I'm happy I got that. This one is the Face Curve. I don't know what to do with this. It's like those typical foundation brushes from the past, but it's a little bit more rounded, I'd say. Maybe that's what it's for. Face Curve. Another face one is the Luxe Sheer Cheek, which is an angled brush, most probably for blushes or even highlights. It's pretty small. Okay, that's good. Last face brush I'd say is the Luxe Fan Brush. Right here. Okay, there. I've got a big fan brush that I use for like blush and contour and bronzer. Bronzer or even highlights. And then I've got a few eye brushes, which is really what I was interested in. So let's see. I've got here the Luxe Crease Brush. So that's what that looks like. I have here the Luxe Smoky Shader. There you go. This one is the Luxe Soft Definer Brush. This one's pinched, so it's like a bit flat on there. Uh-huh. There is this, what is this? Concealer Buffer. This is pretty much rounded. I have something very similar from Real Techniques. This is the Smudger Brush, so it's short. Would be good for like the bottom lash line, I think. This is the Brow Line. There you go. I've got a pencil brush here. Yeah, Luxe Pencil Brush. Looks really nice. Feels really soft. Unlike the Dellium ones that scratched me. I've got here a winged liner brush that looks pretty cool. Ooh, and very, I'm really interested in using that. And then finally here is the spot liner. Ooh, I don't know if you can see that, it's so freaking tiny. Spot liner, I don't know how to use that. I don't know what it's for. I'll probably use it for what it's not intended, but there you go. Another thing that I got, I'm starting with not the most exciting ones. Hans DeFuco Gravity Paste, because as you guys know, I have cut my hair quite short and I do intend to get it shaved on the sides as well, so I'm gonna need some hair products. I did get the Huda Beauty Electric Obsessions palette. I just have to show you guys, this is so small. It is the same size, actually smaller than my Dose of Colors quad. You can see that the Dose of Colors is slightly bigger. And this is a quad. Has got 9 shades in it. I probably don't need that much eyeshadow anyway, and with these colors, this size is actually quite fine for me because I probably won't be using them all the time anyway. But as you guys know, I have been so bored with warm shades that I wanted to get like really nice different shades this time around, so looking forward to using that. I have tried Huda's formula before when I had the Desert Dusk palette. I did like the formula, I just wasn't a big fan of all the reds in that Desert Dust palette. And then lastly, and possibly the most exciting of all of the purchases I've made, is the Marc Jacobs Iconic. This is my first ever Marc Jacobs eyeshadow, and I wanted to go with something that's a little bit more classic that I could potentially use on a daily basis so I can get my money's worth out of it. So this is the Frivo Lux. It won't come out. The Frivo Lux one. Come on. Why won't you come out? There you go. And it's got a hefty packaging. Like, it's got a good weight on it. It's tiny. It's very sleek. I've used Marc Jacobs product before, which was their gel liner, and I was not impressed because people were saying, oh, it doesn't leave your eyes, it stays around or whatever. It didn't work on me. Anyway, this one here, let's open it. I just nicked the purple shadow. Yeah, so this is the colors that it comes with. Let's see, there you go. Colors that it comes with. This one is called Fabulous. This one is Always Fabulous, Always Dress. You got Outrageously. This is How You Want, Who Has Time, How You Want, Who Has Time, and then For Less. There you go. So I've chose the purple ones because I think those are ones that I would wear the most. And if I'm going to pay this amount for this particular eyeshadow, for only 7 eyeshadows, like, I'll show you as well. Typical MAC eyeshadow size is the same as the one here in Dose of Colors. This is the size of the Marc Jacobs one. Right, not the same. This is much smaller. All right, so, but I really wanted one to try out. If I don't end up loving it, I'll probably put it up for sale. I don't know what I'm gonna do with this really gray shade here that's matte. It's really not something that I wear all the time, or not really something that I wear, but all the other shades seem to be something that I would really like. This one here that looks a little bit more pewter, I think I'm gonna enjoy that. Alrighty, so that is my Sephora haul as well as my unboxing of my Bellabox. I do have another US Sephora haul that's coming from my sister. I don't know when it's going to arrive here, but when I do the unboxing of that, I will then give you a little bit of a review of these products that I got from Sephora, if they're worth the money, if they're worth buying. the sun is finally coming out, so hopefully my clothes are gonna dry, and this is what, probably why I'm really bright right now. So I'm gonna end it here. I'm gonna end it here because I've got a mess around me right now. And I'll see you all again in the next video. Let me know if you pick, if you are in Australia and you purchased from Sephora, what did you pick up at the sale? And yeah, that's it. Bye.